We want to determine the intervals for which the function is concave up or concave down, and find any points of inflection. We can determine whether a function is concave up or concave down by determining where the second derivative is positive or negative. If the second derivative is positive, the function is concave up. If the second derivative is negative, the function is concave down. So to begin, we'll determine where the second derivative is either undefined or equal to zero. But before we find the second derivative, we must first find the first derivative. So f prime of x would be equal to 30x to the fourth plus 100x to the third minus 240x squared. And the derivative of 8 would be 0. So here's our first derivative function. And therefore, the second derivative function would be equal to 120x to the third plus 300x squared minus 480x. Well, the second derivative function is a polynomial function, which is never undefined, so we'll go ahead and set this equal to 0 and solve for x. The greatest common factor among these three terms would be 60x, so let's factor out 60x. That would leave us with 2x squared plus 5x and then minus 8. So the second derivative equals 0 when 60x equals 0, or when 2x squared plus 5x minus 8 equals 0. Well, here we can easily solve for x by dividing both sides by 60. And so x equals 0 is one value where the second derivative equals 0. But unfortunately, 2x squared plus 5x minus 8 doesn't factor. So to solve this, we'll have to use the quadratic formula. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So again, we know that x equals 0 is one value where the second derivative is equal to 0. But now we also want to find the 2x values where 2x squared plus 5x minus 8 equals 0. So using the quadratic formula, notice a is equal to 2, b is equal to 5, and c is equal to negative 8. So our solutions would be x equals negative b, or negative 5, plus or minus the square root of b squared, or 5 squared, minus 4 times a, which is 2, times c, which is negative 8, divided by 2 times a, or 2 times 2. So we have x equals negative 5 plus or minus the square root of, this would be 25 plus 64, that's 89, which doesn't simplify, divided by 4. So we have a total of three values of x where the second derivative is equal to 0. We have x equals 0, we have x equals negative 5 minus square root 89 divided by 4, and then we have x equals negative 5 plus square root 89 divided by 4. So now we'll use these three values to divide the domain of the original function f of x, which is all real numbers, into four subintervals, and then test the sign of the second derivative in each subinterval. But I think to form the subintervals, we'll use the decimal approximations for these two irrational values. So to save some time, I've already found the decimal approximations. Notice how I've ordered them from least to greatest. And this will help us form the intervals to test the sign of the second derivative. And again, to save some time, I've already set up the intervals as you see here in the table. We have negative infinity to approximately negative 3.6085, then from negative 3.6085 to 0, then from 0 to 1.1085, and finally from 1.1085 to infinity. And now we'll pick test values in each interval and determine the sign of the second derivative. This is another reason why it's helpful to have the decimal approximations here. It's easier to form the intervals and also to pick test values. So for this interval here, let's test x equals negative 4. Let's test x equals, negative 1 here. Let's test x equals positive 1 here, and we'll test x equals 2 here. To save some time, I've already entered the original function and the second derivative function into the calculator under y1 and y2. If I press y equals, you can see them here. Of course, we could do this by hand, but the calculator should save us some time. And because the second derivative is in y2, to evaluate the second derivative at x equals negative 4, I'll enter y2 of negative 4 on the home screen. So I'm going to press second mode for quit, vars, right arrow, enter, and select number 2 for y2, and in parentheses, negative 4. Notice how the sign is negative. For the next interval, we want to find the function value y2 of negative 1, so we'll press vars, right arrow, enter, option 2, and in parentheses, negative 1. Notice over this interval, the second derivative is positive. In the next interval, we're testing x equals 1, so once again, vars, right arrow, enter, number 2, and in parentheses, 1. Notice how the second derivative is negative over this interval. And then finally, we have a test value of x equals 2. So vars, right arrow, enter, number 2, and in parentheses, 2. The second derivative is positive over this interval. So notice how it alternates negative, positive, negative, positive. Where the second derivative is negative, the function is concave down, which should be over this interval and this interval. And where the second derivative is positive, the function is concave up, which should be this interval and this interval. And now to give the intervals here though, we'll give the exact values again. So the function is concave up over this interval and this interval, where negative 3.6085 was the approximation for negative 5 minus square root 89 divided by 4. So we have negative 5 minus square root 89 divided by 4, comma, 0. And also over the interval from approximately 1.1085, which was negative 5 plus square root 89 divided by 4, comma, infinity. And the function is concave down over this interval here, which is from negative infinity to negative 5 minus square root 89 divided by 4. It's also concave down over this interval here, which is from 0 to negative 5 plus square root 89 divided by 4. And now it does ask for points of inflection, and notice how it does change concavity here at x equals approximately negative 3.6085. Changes concavity here at 0, as well as here at approximately 1.1085. So we have 3 points of inflection, and for the points of inflection, I'm going to go ahead and use the decimal approximations. Now to find the y coordinates though, we do have to evaluate the original function at these x values. So now we'll go back to the calculator, and because we have the original function in y1 here, we can just enter y1 of these inputs to find the corresponding function value. So let's go ahead and clear this. We're at vars, right arrow, enter, enter for y1. In parentheses, we have negative 3.6085. So the function value is approximately 4,334.8156. Next, we have an x coordinate of 0. So again, vars, right arrow, enter, enter, in parentheses, 0. So the function value is 8, so 0, 8 would be a point of inflection. And the last point of inflection occurs when x is approximately 1.1085. So vars, right arrow, enter, enter, in parentheses, 1.1085. So the y coordinate is approximately negative 53.1783. I hope you found this helpful.